everything outside is getting warmer, everything's blooming. I want to just take a minute to kind of talk about allergies and kind of the associated skin issues that go along with them. So here's an example. This is the underside of a dog's neck. You can see we've got a lot of hair loss. You get a lot of crusties going on in the skin. Having this skin that almost looks thicker is really common, especially after the hair loss. And then we can zoom in on this picture as well. This is the same dog, underside of his belly. Again, you can see here all these crusties going on. He's got a lot of hair loss, and it's really, really red. Okay, so dogs with allergies or skin issues in general, they do itch a lot. They tend to get a secondary infection on top of that, so that's where these crusties come in. You get kind of a yeasty overgrowth on the skin. Pets are often allergic to things just like people are. There's usually a combination of environmental and food allergies playing a role in each pet. One thing, one service that we do offer here to try to get a better idea of exactly how to manage each individual pet is we do offer allergy testing. We do that through Spectrum Vet. They come back, they give you a booklet covering everything that your dog's allergic to. They do test it for food and environmental. So this is an example. Comes back, everything red on there is what they're allergic to. It comes with hyposensitization treatments, all that. So that's kind of more of a long-term management thing with it. But what do we do? How do we help this? So as far as this goes, we do have medications that'll help stop the itch. One of the big ones that we reach for a lot is Apoquil with its sister product, Cytopoint. They both work on the individual itch factor of dogs themselves, so they are very effective and they will give you more of that instant relief, okay? Then you do want to treat the secondary skin infection that you have going on as well. So we look at them, we assess them, and we pull the correct antibiotic off the shelf or the correct antifungal. Ears, chronic ear infections often go along with allergies as well. The inside of the ear is just skin. So when it swells, you're going to get that same yeasty overgrowth, just like you get here, but on the inside of the ear. And because it's a nice, dark, moist area, it's going to grow even faster. So dogs with mild allergies, a lot of times will just get these chronic ear infections that come back 2 times a year. Spring and fall, we see it a lot. Some pets are more allergic in the heat of the summer. If your dog is showing you these symptoms of chewing on their feet, bad ears, things like that, in the middle of winter, a lot of times, again, it goes back to having a food allergy. And so we can talk about hypoallergenic diets and diet trials and things like that. So there's a lot of stuff at our disposal to kind of make these guys more comfortable and to help you figure out a better way to manage them long term.